محمد لطفي, professor of cardiology, University of Alexandria. I'm talking to you about the Cairo PCR seminar. This is our second Cairo PCR seminar in Egypt. It's directed by Professor Hazem Khamis. We have the honor that this year to have with us Professor Jean Fajadé, Professor William Wines, and Goron. They are very eminent interventional cardiologists and one who created and initiated the Euro PCR course. This year, we have four items to be discussed during the Cairo PCR. The first was non-left main bifurcations, and we just have very good illustrations and demonstrations of how to treat a bifurcation lesion with the different techniques. And then we have a second session about the treatment of saphenous vein graft intervention with the illustration of how to use the different devices and pharmacotherapy in order to have a good result and outcome for treating this difficult patient subset. And this case was presented and discussed by Professor William Wines. And the second day we have two sessions. The first session was about the treatment of left main bifurcation with use of DK crush technique. Professor Goron showed us very good illustrations about how to do properly the DK crush technique. And Professor William Wines stressed on we have to follow the steps recommended by the consensus of the Bifurcation Club in order to have the similar results with use of the DK crush technique. And the last session will be a treatment of highly calcified in-centric stenosis with the use of rotablator. And in this session, all the attendees will have an idea about how to prepare the rotablator, how to use the rotablator, and to be more friendly to be used in patients with calcified lesion, because in this patient and lesion subset, it is impossible to treat except if you have a rotablator. After each of these sessions, we have four cases presented by our colleagues of Egyptian professors who presented different cases scenario as regards bifurcation, left main bifurcation, in-stent stenosis calcification, and post-CABG intervention. I hope that the journey of the Cairo PCR will continue, and in the next year we'll have more and more of you participating in order to share our knowledge, experience, to improve the management of our patients. Thank you.